And what's up, guys? Today we're gonna be checking out the CarDongle. Now it's supposed to convert any Android Auto vehicle with those dumb infotainment centers. Like I know mine is pretty stupid. With a simple plug and play, converts into a full Android computer PC. We have Play Store and APK side loaders, all that. So let's get into it and test it out. Now, what comes in the box? Well, it's real simple. This thing goes for about 99 bucks, maybe a little bit more. And this is basically it. We can pop out this little tray for expandable up to 128 gigs, I believe. Inside this little guy is an octa-core CPU, 2 or 4 gig RAM, 16 or 64 gig memory. All right, so we're out in my garage. I believe the only requirements needed is that you have a vehicle with Android Auto and a touchscreen. All right, let's get you set up in here. Let's just do a one tap to power that on the door so we don't get that fun beeping. Now I have a little USB slot right here where I'm gonna plug it in. All right, it's booting up, glowing blue. Let's check the screen. Automatically launched right over. Car dongle, car PC, it's booting up. And there we go. Now I already booted this up once or twice. I got it connected to my Wi-Fi, create a hotspot on my phone. You can connect it to your home or your car's Wi-Fi if you wanted to. All right, here we go. We're at the home screen. And as you can see, it's kind of a full-fledged Android-looking system. Now, it's I think it's wrapped in some sort of covering because we don't have full controls, but under here, we can connect to our phone's Wi-Fi for hotspot data, or connect to our Bluetooth for music and calls. There's a few other settings under sound, automatic volume control, touch settings, Bluetooth audio, display, you want to shut off the video over 10 kilometers an hour, clock display on video screen, and change the location of Android nav bar, either left or right side. Other settings, auto launch apps on start. Safe touch, that's interesting. You can skip ads without additional touch while watching video, and then utilize mobile phone GPS as map GPS. So this is one of the major hiccups, I guess, with this, is as you can see, we'll go into Google Maps, and you'll see that it's a little sluggish sometimes. Now, I had first gen, and it was really buggy, and then they've been pushing out some updates, and it's gotten better since then. But it's still not super, like, you know, super computer speed. Go ahead and search. Let's go Chicago, Illinois. There we go. Slowly loading in. So we've got pinch to zoom, multi-touch, all that. So that's kind of cool. You could even get down to street view if you wanted. But yeah, so basically live GPS is not working. Now, I think I heard that that's actually coming in some future update firmware. So maybe the hardware is built into that stick with GPS. Currently, you can use the GPS on your phone, but then I think you have to download some third-party app, which I don't love. So what's cool about this whole system, you may wonder, is like, why would I want this over Android Auto? Isn't it you're doing the same thing? Well, not really. We can load tons of cool apps like Waze, for example. A lot of people love this over other mapping apps. And I don't believe you can get that on Android Auto. That works kind of cool, well, except for the GPS part, but hopefully that works soon. Another thing that Android Auto or none of those others are gonna allow you, except if you have like a Tesla, is let's launch YouTube. We can literally watch almost anything you want streaming while going on a road trip. This is really cool. Let's pull up Authentic. He has one or two cool videos, maybe. So you can see, scrolling's like pretty good. It's not bad. Let's pull up this cool Dualtron. Let's see if audio works. Ah, there's an ad. Oh, look at that little glitching.
All right, let's try this one. Nick is up there.
There we go. Okay, so it's a little pixelated as it loads up.
7, 8 feet or something. He's going to try to clear it from just this little jump. But this thing is so powerful. Let's see if he can hit it and cover it. All right, send it.
Let's get that quality up. How high can we do it? Let's do 1080. That should be good.
This is the Dualtron Storm, probably one of the most powerful and fastest electric scooters I've ever ridden, and it might be my new fakie from Authentech and the
Dual. Ooh, there we go. Look at that quality. It's a bit better. I don't know if this is stuck on the processing power of the stick, or is it maybe just my data?
Storm is the cream of the crop. Specs include 11-inch tires.
Ooh, there we go. Look at that. Volt system. That's great looking quality. Ah, oh, stink. Let's try 720p.
We'll have motors with max speed around 52 miles per hour, a massive battery for 80.
Bummer, I wonder what's going on.
All right, well, you get the idea. I think if you had good enough Wi-Fi data speeds, you might be able to stream better quality. You have Netflix. I didn't sign into that one. I don't know if I'd recommend signing into all your accounts on here, but it might be fun. I don't know. Just do your research, I guess. With the Play Store, we could even download some games. Let's try out Angry Birds. It's a little slow to start up, I guess. Hey, look at that. So that's kind of cool. I'm playing Angry Birds on my old 2018 Chrysler Pacifica. All right, so that's a good example that I was just trying to get to the main menus, and look at it froze. The gears are stuck. So, oh, where are you going? So yeah, the specs of this thing, it's not top tier, unfortunately. I mean, it's pretty, still kind of buggy-ish. Other times I've had Chinese characters pop up with some warning messages. I don't know what they mean. There we go. So here's the Play Store. You could download or sideload APKs, almost anything you can think of. I searched for Disney Plus and why isn't it here? I'm not sure. Amazon Prime Video, HBO Max, Minecraft, get TikTok on here. That'd actually be kind of funny. Endless scrolling while driving. I bet that's real safe. Of course, I'm joking. This should only be used while you're parked or by your passenger. Again, I want to make sure this is clear. It's getting its data, its internet access from either your phone's hotspot or if you have a car that can create a hotspot as well. And then again, if you have apps that aren't in the Play Store, well, you can always sideload those through an APK file manager. That'd be pretty easy as well. So that's cool. All right, now let's get out of here and go back into the office for some concluding thoughts. All right, well, there you go. So concluding thoughts, is it worth 99 or 120 or whatever bucks? Maybe. I think you have to know what you're getting into. So is it gonna run the most smooth? And do you want something that's totally bugless and has GPS working and everything? Well, then stay away. But if you're willing to maybe wait for some possible future updates, well, then it might be worth checking out. Now, I love the idea of having a full-fledged Android OS built into my car and streaming all those apps and music and stuff like that, but I think MKB and others always say, don't buy a product now based upon future promises. So that GPS unfortunately isn't working, which is kind of essential. I'm using maps all the time for navigation and road trips. Of course, you don't have to use it for those certain things. You could jump back into Android Auto for maps or use the built-in one for that, but you get the idea. It's a little bit rough around the edges, so it's worth checking out maybe. I'll give you the link down below. Thanks to those guys for sending one over to try out. And yeah, continue pushing the envelope and try new things. I love to see those sort of experimental products. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one.